Nickel, the unsung hero of our daily lives. The trusty sidekick who never gets the spotlight. Nickel rarely parades around in its pure form. Instead, it gives strength and durability to other materials, especially alloys, that play crucial roles in our kitchens, transportation, renewable energy technologies, and so much more. But how much do we really know about nickel? How can something that is used in so many applications be so, well, mysterious? The fact is, it isn't mysterious, not to us at least. Here at the Nickel Institute and NiPERA, for 40-plus years, we've been fascinated by this elemental enigma. We've been studying it intensively, and we still do, constantly growing a library of scientific information and knowledge to ensure that nickel is used efficiently, sustainably, and most importantly, safely. Nickel is actually a natural part of our ecosystem. It's been here all along as part of our soil and water, and as a nutrient for our plants. Even our vegetables and fruits contain small amounts of nickel. So it's not about nickel's existence, but rather how we handle and use it that determines its safety. Speaking of safety, how do we help to ensure we use nickel in an environmentally friendly way? We've championed an internationally recognized concept called bioavailability, which we use to determine safe levels of nickel for different soil and water ecosystems. Bioavailability describes how the impact of nickel to organisms is affected by the natural components of water and soil. These components vary considerably in nature, and bioavailability allows us to determine the effects of nickel from one ecosystem to another. This ability helps us establish environmentally appropriate working practices for the extraction, manufacture, use, and disposal of nickel and nickel substances. And what about safety of the general public? Nickel can have an undesirable effect that we need to talk about. Nickel allergic contact dermatitis, which results in a skin rash. Yes, it does exist for some. To decrease occurrences of nickel contact dermatitis, the bioavailability concept is applied to humans using a method called bioelution to evaluate potential exposure. Nickel must be released from an object for an allergic reaction to occur. Bioelution for skin exposure to nickel estimates the amount of nickel released from an object by using artificial sweat to help determine the risk of nickel allergy. It's a simple but effective scientific tool that serves as basis for establishing robust regulations and guidelines and helps us ensure the safe use of nickel-containing objects in our everyday lives. In an industrial context, nickel-related health risks can be associated with workplace air and skin exposures, but these risks can be meticulously managed as well. Rigorous science-backed safety measures such as continuous monitoring, exposure limits, and industrial hygiene techniques are available to keep workers and the surrounding environment properly protected. Moving forward, nickel is getting a promotion. The demand for nickel, especially in sustainable technologies, is set to rise. But as demand increases, so does our responsibility. That's why for the past 40-plus years, the Nickel Institute and its members have been stepping up to the plate, advocating for responsible and sustainable practices, and will continue to develop innovative technologies and support research that maximize the positive impact of nickel. We're the Nickel Guardians. We help make sure science, care, and diligence is at the forefront of nickel's extraction, applications, and regulations. We're working to make sure the risks are understood, so we can help to ensure the safety of people and the environment. And there you have it, nickel, the unseen, unsung hero of our daily lives. Oh, and did we mention that it's endlessly recyclable, meaning every item containing nickel on the planet can be safely and responsibly used again and again by future generations? Not bad for a metal that most of us know as little about as the far side of the moon.